Good morning, my dear children. I'm D.K. Mishra. I'll be teaching you maths and physics. So right now, I'm discussing physics, and the chapter is force and pressure. Right? Let us try to understand first force. So in the book, when you go through, it's mentioned that force is a push or pull. Now try to understand why it is called push or pull. For example, when you open the door, how do you open it? You open the door by two methods. Either you are pushing or you are pulling. At many places when you go to the shop, you must have seen it's mentioned pull or push. Obviously, seeing those two words, you realize either you have to push or you have to pull. So I'm mentioning here, force means either you are saying push or pull. Now let me explain again push. So when you say push, that means you are applying the force by the hand against your body. That means the object is going away from you. When you are saying pull, so that means you are bringing the object near you. So that means force in a way is doing two things. Either it is bringing the object near you or it is keeping the object away from you. In the daily life also you see, whatever you do, it is always either near you or away from you. So that is how we understand these two words, that is push or pull. Now let us take few examples. You play. So when you play football, what do? You kick the ball. Now again, when you kick the ball, indirectly you are pushing it by the leg, right? And when you are taking the ball along with you and giving the pass to your fellow players, so there you are doing both the things. You are keeping the ball with you, so somewhere you are pulling the ball towards yourself. So you can see it is your push or pull. Okay, so let us see few more examples where you can realize the impact of force in your daily life. Now say, the first thing, force can change the position of the object. Let us try to understand this line. Force can change. So that means force has the ability to change. Thank you.